As we count down to Easter, there's some worrying news about the future of chocolate.
You see, we're facing a worldwide cocoa shortage, and that's affecting not only chocolate manufacturing, but the price we pay for it.
It's the chocolatey joy of Easter. The one day the sugar content of breakfast is brushed aside with endless chocolate eggs. But another key ingredient of chocolate is the cocoa, and a worldwide shortage of that is causing issues in the market. The chocolate life cycle starts with the cacao plant producing cocoa beans, and the two countries that grow more than half of the world's cocoa have had 3 years of poor harvests, and a fourth is looming. War, adverse weather, and disease have all contributed to it. To make chocolate, though, the raw beans need to be processed into a cocoa butter or liquor. But now the major processors can't afford the beans, so are slowing or even stopping work. Add to that market speculators, traders that hedge bets on a commodity shortage and buy up supplies, which, you guessed it, is driving the price up even more. All this has resulted in cocoa prices more than doubling in the last year. So what does that mean for all of us who just want our chocolatey fix this Easter?
And for more on this, we're joined by the owner of Devonport Chocolate, Sarah Gardner. Thank you so much for your time tonight, Sarah. You've been in the business a long time. How are you feeling about the future of chocolate manufacturing?
Hi, Hilary. Look, it is a really challenging time at the moment. I have to say, we've had some really sleepless nights. Cocoa bean prices have doubled in price over the last 12 months, and we've suddenly seen this decline in supply. So I don't think there's any chocolate manufacturer globally that isn't feeling a bit like there's some tough decisions coming.
Okay, Sarah, so there are obviously the smaller makers like yourselves, but could this also affect the big players?
Absolutely. I don't think you can get a doubling in price of your main ingredient and not be impacted. So we are definitely expecting to see the big boys feel it as well.
Let's talk about prices and what it will mean for prices. How much do you think they'll go up and when? I mean, do people need to start thinking about stockpiling chocolate this Easter?
No, I don't think you do need to stockpile. But there's no doubt you are going to see in the next 12 to 24 months your favourite chocolate go up in price. I think every chocolate business will be taking a look at and seeing how much can we absorb as a business and how much do we need to transfer through to our customers.
So do you see a light at the end of the tunnel, Sarah?
There is light, absolutely. But we just don't know when the light's going to come. Is it going to come in 12 months? Is it going to come in 24 months? We just don't know. So we're going to be watching carefully like everybody else and trying to make really good decisions for our customers to make sure that they still get a beautiful product that they can really enjoy.
And just before we let you go, it would be nice to end on a sweet note. Are you concocting any interesting flavours this Easter?
Oh, we're doing heaps of flavours, which is fantastic. What we've seen globally is that hazelnuts, caramels, dark chocolates are all going to be the rave this year. So we've got all of those in our Easter range and some beautiful marshmallows and things that you two will be trying now, I hope.
Oh, we will. We can smell them right now. Thank you so much, Sarah. Lovely to talk to you.
Yay. Nice to speak to you too. See you.